Hello, it's week 15 of season 5 of the Andy Griffith Show. This week's episode title is Andy and Helen Have Their Day. Barney?
I come into work one morning, and I'm real tired. And I tell Andy that I was out kind of late last night, on a date, out to Norelli's for supper, and then over to her place for TV. And Andy assumes it was Thelma Lou, but I say no, it was Juanita from the diner. And I ask him not to tell anyone. And then Andy says he's going to take Helen to the movies tonight. And I say, you and Helen are in such a rut. You take her to the movies, and then you buy her a soda, and then you walk her home, and it's good night, and that's it. I mean, you could go on like that for years. And then Helen comes in to tell Andy that she can't go out tonight, because she's got too many history teachers to grade. And I say, I have an idea. Why don't you get me those teachers to correct? History, that's my subject. You just get me those painters, I'll have them marked and corrected in no time flat.
But she says no, and then they say to each other that how their jobs so often keep them from spending time with each other, and then they each try to make plans for the rest of the week, but one of them or the other is busy each night of the week.
And then Andy tells her one of these days he's going to take her off someplace, and they'll spend a whole day together. And I say, hey, you just gave me a great idea. You want to spend a whole day together? How about Saturday? I'm making you a present of Saturday. You and Helen. Make a picnic lunch, go out to Nyers Lake, take the whole day. Fish, swim, loaf, do whatever you want. And Andy says he has to take Altie to the movies and take Aunt Dee shopping on Saturday and do stuff at work. And I say, I'll do all that. And then Helen says that she's got errands to do, too. And I say, I'll do all that. No, I'm not taking no for an answer. Saturday, picnic, the whole day together. I'll have Goober drive you over in the truck. So they finally say okay, and Helen leaves. And later I'm telling Goober that his truck don't look appropriate for two people who are romantically inclined. It smells gassy. And Goober says, that's all that's available. And I tell him to wash it up, and he says he'll do that, and he'll put a blanket over the front seat, too. And then I tell him not to talk to them while he's driving them to the lake. And I say, these are two people headed for a rendezvous, and it's just barely possible that as a result, they may get matrimonial intentions.
So then that Saturday, you call Andy to say that Goober's on his way over there. They're getting their picnic basket ready, and you say you've been working on the errands that you promised you'd do, and then Goober picks them up and says he's going to take good care of them, because today might be an important day. And Helen says, why? And Andy says, oh, nothing.
So he helps them carry their stuff out to the lake, and they tell him to take a couple of sandwiches with him, and he misunderstands and sits down and starts eating. And then I come out there, and I tell Helen, you forgot to leave the key to your house. The television repair guy is coming, isn't he? That was one of your errands. How did you figure he was going to get in the house? And she says the guy knows that it's under the net. And then I tell Goober, you take that sandwich and go on back to the truck. Didn't I tell you 100 times they wanted to be alone? And then he leaves, and then I leave.
And then once they eat and start relaxing and kissing, you come by again. And this time it's with Opie. You say you were about to take Opie to the movies, like Andy said, but it's 2 horror pictures playing.
And I say, if it's okay with you, it's okay with me, then I just don't want his warped psyche on my head, that's all. And Andy says those movies are okay. So I say, just go on back to what you were doing, and we leave. Then later I come back again, and they're out in a boat on the lake. And I yell at them to come back in. And when they do, I say, you know, Andy, I'd never do a thing like this to you unless it was absolutely necessary, don't you? I've got George, the TV repairman, with me. And George says he can't fix the set at her house. He wants to take it into the shop. And I say, it's a big job. I mean, I didn't want him to take the set all the way into the shop unless he explained what was wrong so you can make up your own mind, Thelma Lou. And they say, take the set into the shop and not to bother them again. And I say, I just thought I was doing what was best, so we leave.
And then Andy and Helen get taken in by the local game warden because Andy's fishing and he doesn't have his fishing license with him, and it's in another county. And the guy says that the fact that Andy's the sheriff in Mayberry doesn't matter, So Andy has to call the courthouse from the Justice of the Peace, where the warden takes him, and Goober answers.
And he tells Goober to tell me to get over to the Justice of the Peace in Siler City with $25 to pay his fine for no fishing license as soon as possible. That all Goober renders of the message is $25 and license in Siler City Justice of the Peace. And I say, well, this is too good to be true. The old son of the gun, he really went and did it. What do you think about that? They're getting married. It's as clear as day. And I'm the one who did it. So Aunt Dee and Ulti and I get dressed up, and I get some flowers, and I have Goober get some shoes and tin cans to the rear dumped earth of a ride deck, and we go into the Justice of the Peace office, all happy, and Goober starts throwing confetti. And Andy and Helen say they're not getting married. The $25 was just for a fishing license fine.
And then you end up bothering them again the next day at Andy's house to borrow his fishing pole. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week for episode 14.